Hi guys, welcome back to the painting channel. This week it's something a little different, so let's roll the intro. Let's see what happens. Hi guys, as I said at the start, it is something a little different this week. I wanted to do a quick painting, but moreover, I just wanted to have a chat with you about certain things, the way my channel is going, what I've been doing, what I hope to do, and one or two other things just as they sort of come up in conversation. So I'm just going to carry on doing a painting and talking to you. I hope that's okay. I hope you enjoy it. And as always, if you do like this at the end, give it a good old thumbs up. That really does help. Subscribe if you're not a subscriber. That really is good too. Lay down comments underneath. And I'm going to be asking each of you for comments this time. I just want to get your ideas about not just this video, but also other videos that I've done and also those and the way that I'm going to be doing videos, I hope, in the future. And give me some ideas, give me some thoughts. That really will be very precious to me. So in the meantime, I'm just going to get on. Let's paint this painting and let's just have a natter. And I know it's a bit one-sided, but hopefully you'll enjoy it. And give me your thoughts in the comment section underneath. I look forward to reading them later on. Okay, so I'm just going to be doing a very quick watercolour. It is something that I've visited many times before, so some of you may well have seen a similar video. Well, not a similar video, but certainly a video that is sort of along the same lines of this in terms of I'll get a right pen will be good. But yes, just similar sort of thing. And just having a bit of fun with it anyway. So this is just my native Romney Marsh. I'm just drawing a quick bit sketch as we go. But I wanted to talk to you about a few aspects of the way that my channel has been going. Now, I've been doing my channel now for YouTube for I actually joined YouTube in 2009, but I actually didn't do anything to the whole thing until about, I think it must have been about June 2019, and I got the bug to start doing tutorials. Now, I used to film them many, many years ago for different companies, and there are certain companies out there that have got several of my video tutorials on their sort of playlists, as it were, and they were fantastic. I really enjoyed those days. It actually taught me a lot about the filming of art videos as such, although I never really did get into it, and I had hoped to, but I didn't really do that. And it wasn't until get out of the way you it wasn't until when I said to you about sort of mid 19 that I felt that I had this channel doing absolutely nothing. A couple of my video teasers from these companies have been put onto my channel. Not a problem with that, but it had 89 subscribers, and I thought, what's the point of this? I may as well shut it down or do something with it. I chose the latter, to do something with it, and I'm really glad I did, because for a long, long time, many years, over 20 odd years, I've been teaching painting in all media. And so I felt that I would like to do that for everybody as well, and not just my weekly students. I have 4 classes a week in my gallery in Hythe. And although lockdown really put pressure on that and closed it down for many, many months, we are now back underway and my students are coming back, and we are still taking classes and names for other people to join the class. So if you're in the Hythe area and you want some regular classes, physical classes, get in touch, come down to the gallery, have a chat, join one of them. There are 3 each week. But that's not what I wanted to talk to you about, really. I just wanted to talk to you about where my channel's been going, what it's been doing over the last couple of years. And it is just over that 2 year sort of anniversary as such. And I look around at other channels and channels that are been out there many, many years and they do extremely well on both on all fronts, really. They have a massive following. And I looked at many of them when I first started, and I sort of got to the point where I thought, you know, I don't know if I can do this. These are really good channels. They know what they're doing. Their filming is fantastic. Their editing is seems to be top notch. And where do I think I can really get to grips with that? So I really got to a point where I nearly didn't start. And I don't know what, I suddenly decided, no, I'm going to have a go at this. And I put a few videos out there. And one of them was only a 10-minute one on how to paint figures in watercolour. And it's done sort of nearly 35,000 views for my small channel. That's incredible. But that is the exception to the rule. I have a bird video out there on a house sparrow that has done nearly 16,000, I think. And that is my second largest video. But in 2 years, my channel has had lots of responses, lots of followers. And I really am so chuffed at the support that it's got. But it has only grown to about 5,000 subscribers. Now, I remember when I first started that to have got 5,000 subscribers would have been awesome. Really fantastic. I was so looking forward to maybe ever reaching 5,000. And then as 4,500 come and passed, and I felt that, you know, I see other video channels out there that are half the age of mine, and they have got 70,000, 80,000, 20,000, 50,000. And I'm thinking, whoa, hang on. I thought I was doing the right thing. I thought I was doing everything very well. And to a point, I put out these week, I've done everything that the sort of influence for YouTube, those people who come on and tell you what to do, what not to do, and all these things. I followed the advice as closely as I understood it, and none of that's ever been a problem. But I sort of look at it and I think, well, I put these videos out of me painting a picture no different to the one I'm painting for you right now. I put this out every week, every Friday at 3 o'clock, dead on, and I haven't actually missed a week, which is something I'm really proud of. But in doing that, I wonder if I'm reaching the right audience. I'm wondering that, you know, when I see other videos doing slightly different things to me, doing so much better in terms of the viewing numbers and the people that sort of respond to them, all the answers, the questions, the likes, and the following, and the subscriber counts. Not that they are the be-all and end-all. Don't get me wrong. I'm not sort of judging everything by that totally. But it does tell me that maybe I should consider what I'm doing, maybe alter things ever so slightly to allow more people to hopefully enjoy what I put out. I don't know if this is the right call or not. It's sort of a seed that's been germinated a little while ago in me, and something that I've sort of slowly been thinking about, slowly been contemplating over a period of time. I'm just going to dry this off and we'll carry on with this natter. Okay, that's done. Oh, so noisy. Anyway, so I forget quite where I was, but I was sort of trying to figure out how to push my channel more so that people will enjoy the content that I put up there and be more willing to click the subscribe button and get involved to support the channel in a very different way and reach a much better, or not better, because you're all great, but a much bigger audience around the world. And I felt that I tried to touch upon it a few months ago when I went outside and did a plein air video. I'll put the link to that up on that side, I think it'll be. And I did that, and I really enjoyed that because I was able to get a little bit more creative with my filmmaking, such as it is. I'm not a filmmaker, as well you all know. I make mistakes. I do make some. But, you know, I enjoy the process of trying to be more creative with my filming at different times. And when I did that little plein air day in oils, I really sort of had a lot of fun trying to create that, trying to make that work. And albeit I know that, you know, there's a lot of people out there that I didn't dry it off enough. Look at that. Not to worry. There's a lot of people out there that know filmmaking so well. And I learn, I look and I watch and I learn and I try and glean information and try and get that process a little bit more under my belt, as it were. But it's not easy. I mean, none of these things are easy. If it was, then everybody would be doing it. I'm a firm believer of that. But I'm always willing to give it a go, always willing to learn, always willing to try and understand a new aspect of the type of thing that I'm doing. I'm going to make a line of trees up there, I think. There you go. Should have been paying a bit more attention, I think. But it's only a bit of fun while I'm talking to you anyway. But, yeah, so how am I going to change my channel? Well, as I said, I did do this little video, this little oil painting plein air. Plein air is something I really do enjoy. And it's brought about, I mean, I'm a wildlife painter. And if you didn't know this, I have and always have been an oil and watercolourist, but I've also been a wildlife artist. That's all I've pretty much done. And over the years, a lot of wildlife art does mean to say that you do incorporate a lot of landscape. And so it only sort of transpires that, or sort of follows that, you know, you become a landscape painter too. And yes, I have, and that's what I've done. And I sort of, a long time ago, decided that I would do both, and that's fine. And when I got my gallery in Hythe, it seemed natural that I would be doing an awful lot of my native Romney Marshes with regards to landscapes, and also a lot of plein air, because you're doing a lot of plein air painting in Africa and other places. So the whole thing sort of revolves around this central idea of creating wildlife, landscape, or watercolour plein air. And many years ago, I get there in the end, many years ago, I used to have a small van, a small camper van, purpose-built. It was one of these already built jobbies. And it was an old one. And I can't remember the nickname. It did have a little old nickname that went with it. But I had it for many years until, unfortunately, it just got too old, like we all do. And it had to be put out to grass, so to speak. And I couldn't afford to get another one, I've got to say, at the time. And so I just didn't have one. And recently I had to get a new car. And I happened to get what's called a Citroen Berlingo. Now, nothing special in that at all, just another van. This was what we call a multi-space, so it was a sort of people carrier type one. Not that big, but I started realizing that many people have been converting these things into little micro campers and camping vans, and stealth camping, I think, is the term. And another term I keep seeing is van life. And although my videos are not about van life, I've not even done one on my van yet. But I do like the idea of being able to, I've sort of, the last couple of months, I've been converting my van to a small micro camper. Enough to have the comfort of being able to sleep in it, eat, cook, and do all these things in it, and take all my plein air equipment, all my art stuff, and just go off and paint, whether it be for one day and can feed myself, or whether it be overnighting somewhere, that's fantastic, or for a longer trip, say down to Cornwall or up to Norfolk, both two of my most favourite places to go, and, you know, just sort of be able to be where I want to be when I want to be there. Now, I don't necessarily, I'm not saying I'm going to break the law and park in places that's prohibited. I'm talking about sort of being in places where you can overnight, not necessarily can, but overnight, and or campsites where I can be really close to the action very early in the morning or very late at night and just turn up and just go to sleep. I don't need to pitch a tent. I don't need to sort of lay my weary old bones on damp grasses, as it were, and just have some level of comfort. So that's what I've been doing. That's what I've been building for the last couple of months. It's almost finished, and I will do a little vlog on it to show you where I'm at with it, what's been going on, my thoughts behind it, which does present me with the last part of this video. I'm just going to dry this up, and then we'll just come back and conclude and let you get on with your day. Okay, so that's dried off, and I'm coming in with a smaller brush now and just conclude this part of the chat, or this video, really. It was meant to be just a bit of a natter and tell you my thoughts, but I've sort of told you roughly about the plein air side. I want to bring more to my channel. I want to bring in other aspects. I want to not just be the person that sits down here once a week, and that's what I've been doing for 2 years now, is sitting down, painting a picture either in watercolour or in oil, and putting it out there at Friday at 3 o'clock for you to enjoy, comment on if you wish to. But the amount of comments and the amount of people watching it compared to the amount of subscribers that I've got are very minimal. I mean, I've got over 5,500 subscribers at the moment, and I think there's only sort of 300-400 a week that are watching the videos I put out, and it may not be the same people, may not all be subscribers. And it makes me wonder if I need to do more and put more content or different content to my channel. So the idea is that I will be creating different videos. And I don't know what I've done here. I've done something to my reference. There you go. I'm going to be doing different videos over the time. And they are, I'm still going to be doing the painting videos as much as I can. There won't be as many, got to be said. There is going to be a bit of a change to those. There will be some, but not as many. And at the same time, I want to bring in a little bit more about what I'm doing, more about me as an artist, more about discussions, about what I'm thinking, why the, you know, lifestyle about me as an artist. What really makes me tick, and my thought processes when I'm creating art. And, you know, I've been creating art for YouTube for, as I say, 2 years, and I feel that I've not been creating total art for myself, and I want to get back to doing a little bit of that, but I want to still share those processes with you guys and give you that information. I also want to bring in this sort of van life, and it's not, I keep calling it van life. It really isn't van life, wrong colour. It's plein air life. It's about me and getting out there and using the van as a means to create some plein air. And it's those videos that I want to share with you also. I want to show you how I go about my plein air painting, how I enjoy the van, how I think when I'm out on the road and what I get up to. And, you know, it's about painting plein air, using the van, enjoying my life as an artist and creating other things that I do while I'm out there. And I'm not sure if I'm explaining that too well. It's pretty hard to explain and paint pictures at the same time, but hopefully you'll get the gist of what I'm trying to say, and hopefully you'll understand. And I do hope that whilst I'm doing those sorts of videos that you are enjoying them enough to continue to follow and support my channel, as you've all done, and I appreciate that. And I do hope that I can reach out to an even bigger and wider audience of people that may enjoy plein air, they may enjoy the van life aspect, the lifestyle aspect of what I'm doing. I don't know. It's all trial. It's all worth just playing around with in trying to create a channel that gives a good degree of quality of content on it. And that's my aim. I love creating for YouTube. I love creating for my Patreons. My Patreon is a different animal in many ways. They are tutorial videos and they are there to help my patrons grow, and everything else is centered around that process. But my YouTube channel can be, if it wants to be, can be something different. And I think that's where I want to take it. I want to build upon what I've done and try and make it better, more interesting, and certainly better for people to want to come back and visit my channel many times over in the future. I'm not sure they will. I do hope so. I hope I don't lose people by doing this, but I really do hope that you'll stick with me and give me some encouragement in the fullness of time by supporting the channel, adding your comments, and all those normal things that I ask you to do if you don't mind. And subscribing, that really is always important. But, yeah, and you know, it's not always about the subscriptions. It's not always about whether people comment. It just, all of those things help. And I just like the idea, if people are enjoying what I put out there, to, yeah, just want to get more involved. But, you know, it's like I was told, I mean, I'm rambling a little bit. I do apologize. But many people sort of turn around and say, well, you should niche down. You shouldn't do all the different things you do. Not specifically to me, general. It's a general comment for some of these people that create content for people like me to learn from about how to make videos on YouTube. And yeah. And so my dilemma has been that I paint in all medium and I love pastel pencils, pastels, watercolour and oil, and even acrylic and charcoal and all these things. And I've been teaching all of them for years. But when I started realising that for a good deal of time that actually my channel was suffering because I was doing all the different media on that channel, all the different things from past, well, everything. And I then decided to cut that back down just to oil and watercolour. And nothing else. And there has been a slight improvement in what I've been doing. More people have been watching and looking and different things like that. But when you look at my channel, when you look at the numbers, my oil videos get far fewer views than my watercolours. Almost half as many to what the watercolours get. So it makes you wonder whether or not I should even cut out doing oil paints on my thing. I would hate that because half of me, well, more than half of me is an oil painter. So I'd actually hate to have to sacrifice doing oil painting videos and tutorials in just for watercolour. But if it's what it meant, I'd have to give it consideration. That all said and done, by changing the way that my videos are going, changing the way that I'm creating work and what I put out there, then the plein air can be both oil and watercolour as well, because it's more about plein air. It's more about the lifestyle of what I'm doing. And I'm just, this video is getting too long. I'm just checking the timing. It's at nearly 30 minutes. So I'm just going to wrap this little painting up and call it a day. It's probably not finished, but I think the chat has probably worn you all out. And I think I better stop there and wish each and every one of you a happy time painting and enjoying the work that you're creating. I'm just going to put a few things in it just to finish this off, a couple of little posts. But I hope you don't mind my ramblings and my thought processes. I did want to just share that and share with you that there will be changes to the channel. I hope they're good changes. I hope you'll stick with me. I hope you'll share the videos. I hope you'll tell other people. And I hope you subscribe and support. So, yeah, thanks ever so much, guys. And thanks for putting up with this little natter as well, even though it's not one of my normal videos. But the next one will probably almost certainly follow hot on the heels of this one. It will be a vlog based around what I'm doing, the van and everything else. So, yeah. Catch you all soon. Take care. Have fun. All the best. Bye-bye.
Nothing ever felt as good or as easy as when we were young. Oh, oh, oh. Though I felt misunderstood, it was a pleasure running away with you. We were just children acting like a doll, crazy, naive, bold and carefree. We were kids having kids, crazy, naive. It amazes me that we didn't fall apart harder than we did. Now they keep us on speaking terms. We grow and we learn. I have no regrets, only forget. A big thank you to life for giving us end. Oh, when the timing's right, there's no wasteland. Oh, we were just children acting like a doll.